We Can Do It! Programang hatid ay kwentong buhay na puno ng inspirasyon at aral mula sa ating mga kababayan worldwide. We Can Do It! Dito lang sa inyong 702 DZAS, FEBC Radio TV.
Magandang araw po uli sa inyong lahat, mga kaibigan. 30 minutes uli ang ating pong
We Can Do It!
Ang We Can Do It nga po ay mapapakinggan at mapapanood sa 702 DZAS Radio TV, sa Facebook Live, YouTube channel, sa 702 DZAS Radio TV every Sunday, alas 6:30 ng gabi. Ganun din po sa channel 185, GCTV tuwing Sabado, alas 6:30 ng umaga.
Yes! Yes. Hi, naku, welcome once again sa ating program at ating mga suki. Tan, they're so sweet and so
thank
nice.
Thank you so much.
Thank you talaga sa mga short notes ninyo and then mga short notes ko din na answer na we're just one in the Lord. I know that our spirit is one when we just enjoy together what the Lord has been doing in each of our lives.
Kayo po ay big encouragement sa amin kahit po malalaki na yung aming sa mga responsibilities po natin. But no complaints. We are doing what God has called us to do. Or possibly, baka masyado nating pinupush ng gusto yung lahat na overcommitments. At yung nagko-continue tayo sa discussion since last week. Ano?
Yeah, oo.
Kaya... I mean, that's me. I'm just also talking to myself. Mm-hmm. But the good thing is, we can do it sa tulong po ng Panginoon.
Yeah, it's just a matter of balancing our time. Mm-hmm. Kumisan kasi na overdo natin yung what we can do for the Lord. But ang importante, what the Lord can do in us, yun ang importante kasi we're so... Ang dami talaga magagawa,
right,
no?
Right.
In the church, ang dami magagawa, but... Teka muna, take your time. Ano naman ang magagawa mo, Lord, sa akin?
Mm-hmm.
Anong gagawin mo sa akin?
Mm-hmm.
And then, with all of the things and the people that we have to adjust to, ayan, sa tabi natin yan.
Right.
We got to adjust to each other.
Correct. Mm-hmm. Well, tama yung, and I totally agree, Ate Maru, dun sa sinabi mo. Kasi tayo, kuminsan, you know, we want to perform. You know, action-oriented din tayo.
Correct.
Work is okay. It's great. Plano ng Diyos yun. Nung ginawa ng Diyos si Adan, pinagtrabaho niya kagad. Ano? Pero yung sense of identity natin ay hindi dahil sa trabaho natin.
Tama.
Ang sense of identity po natin kung ano yung what's mine? Kung hindi na ako makapagtrabaho.
Oo.
Kung ako'y nandun na lang sa isang sulok at hindi na ako makakilos, makakapagpasalamat pa ba ako sa Diyos? Right? Yun ho yung fulfillment natin. My only fulfillment is the Lord. Because one day, it could happen to me. Na hindi na ako makabiyahe and hindi na ako makagawa ng mission trip for the Lord, it's not the mission trip. It's the relationship of God's goodness in our lives because of His grace and mercy.
Kasi may season sa buhay natin.
Yes,
there's
yes.
a time to work and there's time to play also. Diba sabi sa Ecclesiastes?
Mm-hmm.
Kaya iba-balance natin. But there are times when you really have to sit down and listen to God.
Right. Mm-hmm.
God, what is it that you want me to do? Kasi ang ministry natin for the Lord, ano naman ang ministry ni Lord sa atin?
Mm-hmm.
Kung hindi naman tayo nakikinig sa kanya din.
Right.
We're just so busy doing things. But very good. Because, you know, the Lord has been dealing with us in such a way na we listen to Him.
Yeah.
Yun ang maganda.
At yun ho, pag nakinig na tayo sa Kanya, naintindihan natin yung fulfillment natin ay sa Panginoon, ay mas lalo tayong paalisin ng Panginoon and gagamitin tayo ng Panginoon. Ang ibig kong sabihin nung, hindi paalisin, pupunta tayo sa ibang bansa, or you know, merong ipagagawa ang Diyos sa atin kasi nandun na yung closeness natin sa kanya, and he will always tuturuan niya tayo, sasabihin niya tayo, sige, dito ka na lumakad. Para bang si Moses, no? Yung first 40 years niya, he owns everything, he owns Egypt, and he wants to be the savior of Israel at that time.
Yeah.
Pero hindi. Tinanggal ng Diyos lahat.
Ng 40 years
after, siya. Yeah, 40 years.
Shepherd siya. Naman shepherd, siya. Iba naman yung ginagawa.
This is my day-to-day life
yeah.
as a shepherd. And nung wala na siya, saka siya tinawag ng Panginoon.
Tama.
Sabi ng Panginoon, sige, ready ka na. Ikaw na gagamitin ko para iligtas ang Israel.
Right. I remember the life of Martha and Mary also, no? Si Mary wants to spend time with the Lord. Doon na siya, makikinig siya talaga, Doon siya malapit siya kay Lord. Si Martha naman, trabaho na ng trabaho. Yes, so nagre-reklamo siya. Bakit di ba naman ako tinutulungan dito sa ginagawa ko? Then, ano ba sabi ng Panginoon? Mas gusto ni Mary to spend time with me.
Yes, yes. And that is more important.
Correct.
For at this very moment.
Yes, yes. Yeah. So, yeah. Oh.
Hindi ho ibig sabihin na hindi tayo maglilingkod. You know? Hindi tayo tutulong sa kusina. Tutulong din tayo sa kusina. Pero meron talagang time na makipag-ugnayan lang tayo sa ating Panginoon.
So, yeah, and we'll have to seek Him first talaga sa ating buhay.
And then, Ate Maruy, kaya nga ito yung section natin, FPBC International, ano? Kasi ito, nasi-share ko yung mga what I go through.
Yeah.
Yung jet lag, yung traveling, yung, kasi yun yung pinagagawa sa iyo ng Panginoon. So you always go back. Always go back sa salita niya na iyon yung magsusustain sa iyo. Nagkausap kami ng misis. Umalis nga ako. Pumunta ako ng Thailand. And meron pa akong isang lugar na pinuntahan. Kaya lang hindi ko ho pinopost yun sa Facebook dahil ibang ano ho yan. I'd like to protect the security ng ating mga partners.
That's right. Kaya
Ate Maroon, yung nagpunta tayo ng Thailand, I can talk about Thailand.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
You were saying something.
Son. Yeah, I was about to ask you, Tan, kasi you have three kids.
Mm-hmm.
And these three kids are not staying with you anymore. Kasi grown up na ito, mga professionals na to, no?
Right.
So they have to go somewhere else, to live somewhere else.
And, I kicked them out of the house. No. Sabi ko, flap your wings.
I know. Wings. So, parabang, I'm done with my kids. No, they're not in the house anymore. Have you ever said that to yourself? Oh, bahala na kayo sa buhay niyo kasi malaki naman kayo. How is the fatherhood and child relationship with the three?
That's a very good question, Ate Maru. Well, you know, being a father is always there, pero iba na yung role mo. Advisory ka na.
Correct.
Hindi ka na yung you're on top of them, you know, or okay, ito gawin mo, blah, blah, blah. Ito yung, kahit nga nung mga teenagers sila, nung we were on top of it, talagang nagre-rebel din na eh. I guess my style of leadership is I'm not a controlling person. Pero balanse naman kami ni Mrs.
That's
Dawn.
Right.
You know,
that's
yung, right. I'm not saying controlling siya. Pero siya yung more motherly.
Iba kasi ang puso ng nanay.
So tamang-tama, balance kami. Ako mas relax ako.
Mm-mm.
And pero ngayon, I love our time together kasi nami-miss ko sila, pupunta sila sa bahay, weekends, ganyan. So nakikita nila 'yon. And I'm always reminding them, look, you've seen God's faithfulness in our lives. Nakita niyo 'yon. Obvious na obvious 'yon sa kanila. Mm-hmm. And I always remind that kayo'y patuloy na maglingkod sa Panginoon. Hanapin nyo. And own your faith.
Mm-mm.
Own your faith kasi hindi nyo makikilala ang Panginoon sa faith ng mga magulang nyo. Eh.
Mm-hmm.
Makikilala nyo ang Panginoon sa sarili nyong pagsisiliksik sa Kanya. And I know, very supportive sila sa akin, si Mrs. Yun nga lang, ito naman yung scenario ko ngayon pagka bumabiyahe ako, Ate Maru.
Yeah.
Si Mrs. nag-iisa.
Oo.
Kaya salamat sa Diyos. God provided us Meron ho kasi kami mga exchange students
na
from Japan.
Mm-mm.
So,
keeps her busy also.
Yes. Tsaka kitang-kita ako sa misis ko yung pagiging motherly niya. Kasi yung mga Japanese students na ito ay nagiging anak niya.
Talagang, extension talaga ng family. Yeah.
Yeah, mahal na mahal na yung mga Japanese students. And they all know that they, you know, their mom. Kasi tawag sa amin, mom and dad.
Mom and dad.
And they love them. That they love
so
us so
cute.
Much. Yeah.
So
and
cute.
Definitely, we share the gospel to them. Mm-hmm. We share Jesus Christ to them. At least, not at least, we sowed the gospel to them. Kasi pagka magpipray kami sa pagkain, we always say we are Christians, we are followers of Jesus Christ, and we pray.
Yeah.
So sa kanila, may term sila na itadakimasu. Yung magpapasalamat din sila sa pagkain.
Itadakimasu.
Mm-hmm. Itadakimasu.
Itadakimasu.
Yeah. So ito sabi ko, ito naman yung itadakimasu namin. Mm-hmm. And we're talking to Jesus Christ and we are thanking him.
Ganda naman. Tingnan mo nga naman ang Panginoon has a way of comforting his children.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So Ate Maru, pag ito prayer request, sa October, babiyahe na naman ako. So, pag-pray mo na meron kaming Japanese students kasi schedule yan eh. Itadakimasu.
Itadakimasu.
Iitakin kita. Para ikaw ay ano ka, ibakulod ka eh. Di ba? Malambing kayo eh.
Oh,
iitakin kita. Yun ho ang FEBC International natin. We're just sharing our lives to you.
That's right. And thank you. Some of the experiences, mga kaibigan, came from you also as our listeners, our dear listeners. So we just have to have a short break and we'll be right back with a special guest. Back sa ating program, Tan. Napakaganda at naka-bless na bless tayo after hearing those FEBC Radio International News. Ano? Mm-hmm. Talagang nagpapatuloy sa ating paglago sa kanya at sa ating mission din sa buhay, is to serve.
Yeah, Ate Maru, you know, I'd like to connect that kasi nga yung guest natin ngayon ay babanggitin naman yung mission ng Panginoon sa buhay nila, sa family. Kaya lahat po tayo pwedeng ma-involve sa mission ng Panginoon.
Yeah, okay.
Mission Day.
Alam mo, last week, I forgot to mention that the very first singing group na na-form when I became a Christian is a trio with the two Lobaton sisters, si Toto Lobaton,
and
then si Bebot, and then myself.
I see.
We had the trio.
So ano yung pangalan ng grupo niyo?
Ano nga bang pangalan ng trio na I forgot?
The Clarion Singers, siyata kayo ng The Clarion Singers with Manong Jun Galope.
Oh, yeah.
They were always the icebreakers for the evangelistic crusades.
Yeah, right.
Amazing.
So we have been singing in small churches, sa barrio, sa kung saan-saan may evangelistics. We were brought by Manong Jun Galope.
So sa Young Life, sa IV,
correct.
Sa lahat ng mga gatherings. Well, connecting with IV, Ate Lina, no? Kasi my daughter is now full-time staff ng IV.
Yeah, wow.
Cal State Long Beach. But anyway, we need to introduce you again.
Oh, yes. We would like to welcome back our special guest, which you enjoyed last week. Narito siya to give us more of hindi lang bird's eye view, but it's the big view of how the Lord has led them to this particular mission in Bacolod and in Negros Occidental as a whole. And we siya po ay I don't know, but pagkausap mo siya ay non-stop because she has a lot of things to share.
Aha, tapos yun pa yung training niya, maskom.
I know, maskom. Tayo maskom din. Ako maskom din ako.
Maskom. Maskom po tablet ko kung kasama kita, Ate Daru.
Mas committed ako kay Lord. But anyway, let's welcome back to the program Akilina Lina Bukay Lubaton Javier. Welcome back, guys.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Yeah. And we have been seeing at the background last week about some footages about what is going on in Bacolod and in as far as the mission is concerned. Mm-hmm. We are actually, she will be sharing to us paano nag-umpisa ang Lubaton for Jesus mission, evangelism, and discipleship.
Yes.
And this has started maybe lately lang or how many months ago. So malalaman po natin yan kay sa ating guests. Welcome back once again, Kai.
Thank you. LFJ or Lubaton for Jesus is officially 9 years and a half. Mm. On February 14, 2023, we will be celebrating our 10th year.
Oh, wow.
And by God's amazing grace, He has given us the partners who becomes our foot soldiers, that so that when we go to places to evangelize and share God's word, mm-hmm. it is my belief that it is not fair to share God's word without helping the new believer navigate in their newfound treasure of a faith. Mm-hmm. Because if not, they will be plucked by the birds of the air. So discipleship came in as a component of the LFJ.
Right. So, Kai, we would like to know, how did it start? How did it start?
It was in 2013 when Daday wanted to go to the Philippines for 2014 medical mission with Rotary Club.
Si Daday used to one of our guests before, Marjorie Loxine.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And so she said, try to help me.
Yes, my ministry is as a homeless. Deepa. Yes.
Mm-hmm. So help me. I just want to share trucks. So I said, okay, I tried to help her organize her schedule and everything. And when I finally gave her the schedule, she said, Kai, I cannot do it. This is not my forte. I was just thinking of sharing trucks. But then I said, if you ask my help, I have to do the whole package. I cannot do one after the other. If not, malunod ka. Madula ang pulong sang Diyos. So, Talia, sige na, Kai. I said, I will not go because I have a patient.
Oh, kasi
so my lesson was a testimony of Jonah. So the Lord said, you have to go. I said, Lord, I cannot. I have a patient, right? And lo and behold, without any reason, my patient got sick and my patient died.
Right? Okay.
Then the Lord said, may rason ka pa? I said, yes, I cannot go because in my job as a caregiver, no work, no pay. Thinking homeless ang pamilya ko. Mm-hmm. Lord was really specific. He said, just get a break of 3 months. And I did. Here I am, Lord. I followed, not knowing like Abraham what was in store for us.
Right.
It was a time to renew faith, renew relationships and acquaintances. And I saw that the harvest was great. Mm-hmm. And then after that, I said, okay, Lord, paano to? Who will be our foot soldiers? So I invited some pastors, 2 pastors in particular, who were the scholars of my mom and dad in the Bible school, to be our foot soldiers and follow through the souls that we've harvested for the Lord. Mm-hmm. And from the 2, it became 8 now. Mm-hmm. And from just doing Bible studies, we have now so many ministries. We have pastoral support. We have feeding programs, we have cottage prayer meetings, we have mountain ministries, we have youth programs, we have scholarships. Some volunteers who likes to pursue ministry, then we sponsor them and bring them to Convention Bible College to become ministers.
Right.
And the most crowning glory is the Lubaton for Jesus Lighthouse, which is the building that was envisioned by my sister Daday for 25 years finally came into being to house the Lobaton family going to Bacolod, as well as missionaries and laborers of God's Vineyard who don't have a place to stay in Bacolod.
So itong place na to, yung lugar ay it's open for those who want to go there and do missions sa Bacolod at saka sa surrounding areas.
Sa Negros Occidental.
And at the same time, you could use that pagka kayo yung mga uuwi sa Pilipinas. Ganun po ba?
Yes. Yeah.
Wow. I'm curious, Ate Lina, doon sa mountain ministry. Anong ibig sabihin na?
Mm-hmm. So, Alpha and Omega, two brothers, one was really very talented and he said, Nanay, I really like to go to the mountains. So in 2018, finally, we went to the mountains and to do the outreaches. We have to walk about 7 kilometers down, rugged road, putik and lutak and everything, but it was most rewarding. So people there, a lot of them were NPA infested then. Wala na. There are now soldiers for the Lord.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
So there were, he just started visiting people in Palala, Balagong Kagay, Olunganon. Now it is Puerto, Marcelo, and all other places in Calatrava and Escalante. And it's booming.
Oh wow.
And he has other foot soldiers helping him out. So we have become a network expert for the Lord. The only thing that we believe is you share that the elements of your faith. You have to make sure that you believe in the message of the cross, John 3:16. You share that. And when you share that, you have to make sure you abide in the Lord. You remain in the Lord. So you can experience the promise of abundant life that He promised to those. You don't have to die to experience joy and happiness in the Lord. Ngayon pa lang. And then you go to secret of the vine. And that is the secret. You abide in Him so that you can experience the fruit of His Spirit. And when you are so familiar with Him, you don't just call Him Savior. You don't just call Him Lord. You now call Him Father. You call Him Beloved. And when you are so intimate with Him, you can dare Him. So this is a journey of faith in daring God. God like Jabez. I dare you. I claim my inheritance now. My inheritance from Him.
Yeah. Wow. Ate Lina, I have a question doon sa continuation of ministry. Ano? Sabi mo nga, mayroong dalawang pastor na nung nagsimula kayo. Ngayon, walo na. Sila po ba ang nagko-continue habang wala kayo dyan sa Bacolod, paano po ang operation, yung organizational structure then? I'm just curious.
Yeah. So essentially, I'm the founding daughter and sister for the LFJ. So it takes a lot of walking the talk. You have to put your money where your mouth is, John.
Right.
I don't believe that I should beg for support to support the pastors. I believe in something, I dare God to do it. And then people just come in to share the principle of gifts and graces. So you welcome others. You welcome others. Kung bagat pa naging symphony orchestra conductor na lang ako. What can I do? And you know what? People love to celebrate their love for the Lord, John. You just have to make sure you know how to inspire them and to motivate them. Do not be exclusive. You have to be inclusive.
So yung pong operations ay tumatakbo every day, right?
Yung
ministry.
Yes.
And so you have people there in place. And at the same time, there are volunteers helping you.
It's the power of God's voluntarism, spirit of voluntarism.
Nice.
Yes. That's good. Wow. Yeah. You mentioned then, about Escalante.
Yeah, but then all of this, John, is based on our celebration of love for Jesus, but knowing fully well that we also have to be good stewards. So with it, we always uphold the principle of ownership of your faith, ownership of your of your love for the Lord, but at the same time you have to be accountable for the choices you make.
Right.
It's not an easy road, John.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But then it's a give and take. And that's where the power of God's amazing love comes into play.
Yeah. Amen.
So meron pong mga simbahan na you're working together with sa mga walong pastor
ngayon. We have foot soldiers, sila, no? But we have church partners as well.
Yes. I see. Okay. So that makes it
As a matter of fact, the best reward that the Lord gave me in my 10-week trip recently, because palagi how do I get partners? It's always through intense prayer. But this time, the Lord said, you just sit down. He gave me two groups of people who became my partners. One is the Youth United of Minapasok and Escalante, comprising of 7 youth organizations in those two places. Mm-hmm. They said, Nanay, we want to be partners with LFJ. So they embrace the principles of discipleship and evangelism, and they do it on their own. So we partner with them in terms of programs. Another group is the Christian Musicians of Negros. If you know Earl Villalba, the younger brother.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So he retired and he organized a group of Christian musicians, which is focused on teaching young churches to do their music ministry of praise and worship.
Wow.
And then there's another one that is already coming, and that's the Livelihood Program. We're cooking it at the moment that we speak. This is to help members or partners of the LFJ to become self-sufficient, so that in turn they can also do their own celebration of love for them.
Well, definitely, Auntie Lina, alam ko you're investing a lot here, you know, time-wise and also monetary, right? But are there some other agencies or churches who are supporting you financially?
Only God.
Amen.
Dare God to the limit.
Dare
God to the limit, and He has not failed.
Alam mo kay, you mentioned about Escalante. That's where I was born, and I'm glad that there are some outreaches in there. Maybe God willing, one day I might be able to go and just, you know, minister to my kababayan sa Escalante.
Yes, Maru.
Mm-hmm. I'd love to do that someday.
John, I want to invite you and Maru to come with us. It's so fulfilling. Sabi nga ng mga anak ko, Mama, wala ka ng retirement money. Mm-hmm. Sabi ko, anong walang retirement money? Ando na sa langit.
Ando na kinless.
I never regret it, John. And I will keep doing it.
Yeah, Adelina, ang gawain po ng Panginoon, it's always exciting, right?
Exciting and fulfilling.
I'm just happy to see you and then Ate Maru connecting. And that's why we are encouraging our listeners, our viewers, to be part of what God is doing around, you know, in their influence, their sphere of influence.
That's right.
John, can I say something?
Oh, yes.
I don't want to be misconstrued that you have to be doing highfalutin projects for the Lord. No.
Yes.
You have to start within yourself.
True.
Just say, Lord, how can I celebrate you in my life? And you know what? When we really have our eyes open, there are so many opportunities
in
our family, in our neighborhood. And then it will just morph. The Lord will bless the little mustard seed effort that we give for Him.
Amen. Wow, guys, thank you so much for sharing this ministry, and I'm just praying na maraming would be able to catch up with this ministry extension of what you're doing in another way, but then thank you for using your life, your whole family, as a dedication to the Lord as you worship and as you do all this mission. Thank you so much.
I'll be all the glory.
Yeah, maybe next time we'll have some reports from you.
Right. Well, we're blessed, and I know our listeners, our viewers are also blessed.
Yes.
Ito nga po ang programang We Can Do It. Nakikinig po kayo sa ating pong stasyon, sa Radyo TV 702 DZAS, sa Facebook Live, sa YouTube channel ng 702 DZAS Radyo TV every Sunday alas 6:30 po ng gabi. hindi na ako ubunin, Auntie Maru. Dahil siya sa Channel 185 GCTV tuwing Sabado, alas 6:30.
Ayun. At sa pangalan ng ating special guest, Lina Lobaton Javier, ito po si Ate Maru Cepeda Javier.
At ito naman po si Jonathan Mortiz, nagsasabing,
We can do it!
Inyong narinig ang We Can Do It dito lamang sa inyong 702 DZAS FEBC Radio TV, Agapay ng Sambayanan.